This is the Taylor Mountain site where serial killer Ted Bundy dumped the remains of at least four of his victims. On Sunday, March 2, 1975, two forestry students stumbled across a human skull at this location. When King County Detective Robert Keppel arrived at the scene, he soon realized that the silver filings on the upper teeth matched the dental records of missing 22-year-old Brenda Ball. The young woman had seemingly vanished 9 months earlier after leaving a dive bar in Burien. Although the authorities were aware that a killer called Ted was targeting young women in the Seattle area, they did not believe that Brenda Ball's case was related to the other missing girls. In their opinion, the MO and the victim profile didn't match. However, the gruesome discovery at Taylor Mountain quickly proved them wrong. During the second day of the investigation, Detective Robert Keppel was examining the wooded area when he tripped over a branch and stumbled across an unexpected sight. On the ground before him lay a second skull. The victim was Susan Elaine Rancourt, an 18-year-old college student who had been abducted from Ellensburg in April of 1974. Following this discovery, it immediately became clear to detectives that they were dealing with another one of Ted's dump sites. 6 months previously, a pair of grouse hunters had uncovered the killer's other site at a wooded area near Issaquah. These two burial sites were only 12 miles away from each other. At that point, a large-scale operation was launched and a team of search volunteers were called in to comb the area for evidence. During this operation, ESR volunteers discovered another skull and mandible. These remains proved to be a match against the dental records of missing women Roberta Kathleen Parks and Linda Ann Healy. This find was so significant that it forced Keppel and the other detectives to reevaluate many of their original theories about Ted. Up until that point, they believed that he was solely focusing on university campuses in and around the Seattle area. However, Brenda Ball's murder made it clear that the killer was willing to change his MO by abducting hitchhikers. Furthermore, he had also strayed far outside of his comfort zone by kidnapping Roberta Kathleen Parks from Corvallis, a town which was more than 250 miles away. Consequently, the authorities were now starting to realize that the man they were looking for was prepared to branch out and vary his crimes.